Oh, JMO, I think that rebuild is over. I think the Rangers are moving into the next era of New York Ranger hockey. They do get Panarin on the big deal, Dan. And think about what the Rangers have done over the last several weeks with adding, you know, Kako to the mix as the second overall pick. They added Adam Fox. Nobody's going to be talking about him anymore. He'll be a nice player for them. Jacob Trouba, that contract, wait to be seen where that's going to be, but that's going to be significant. But this team has changed dramatically, and I don't think they're done. They may decide to move a few other pieces around.
Well, yeah, I mean, because what do they do now with Chris Kreider? That's the question here. What do you do with Chris Kreider when you have him? He's your second line left wing, but if you need the cap space to sign Jacob Trouba, right, EJ, which they do, and they just gave all the money to Panarin, what happens with Kreider? There's been a lot of talk about a trade for him. It's really either a trade or a re-sign at this point, and they don't want to go. They're not going to be in the position to go into next season thinking they could be a seller at the deadline again with Chris Kreider. Oh, maybe we'll get a first-round draft pick. Those days are over for the New York Rangers. Signing Panarin, Trouba, Fox, Kako, this signals the end of the rebuild, like we've been saying. They're on to the next phase now. They're on to the win now, get in the playoffs phase. I talked to David Quinn about this at the draft. He thought last year, halfway through the season, they were a team that was projecting to, if things would fall into place, maybe make a push. But he also knew it was coming with Hayes and Zuccarello and McQuaid. Like, you knew it was coming. That's not coming next season. They got to make the playoffs now. They make this move. This is getting in. They got two more years of Henrik Lundqvist. This is making moves to make those 2 years with Henrik Lundqvist matter.
Yeah, and they traded Jimmy Vesey away earlier today to create some more cap space. I still look at their team down the middle. I love Zibanejad, but after that, it's still not strong down the middle. So I'll be curious to see if that's an area they try to address. Maybe by moving Kreider or someone else.
Yeah, it could be by moving Kreider or someone else, or maybe they go into the season with Ryan Strome in that position or Philip Hedel. I mean, remember, they got Hedel and they got Elias Anderson in the draft. These are the guys, they were first-round picks. They're supposed to come up. You look at that board there. If Kreider comes off of it, my guess is Hedel bumps up into Kreider's spot. He doesn't play the center spot. He goes over to the wing where he played last year. Or they move Strome over to the wing if they really want to keep Hedel there. And you jump Elias Anderson in, probably in that third-line center spot to play with Kravtsov and either Lemieux or Namestnikov. So there's moving parts there for sure. If Kreider's dealt, if he's not dealt, then he obviously plays in that spot. And then do you play Hedel in the second-line center role or Strome? I mean, they have options to look at.
Nice to have options.
They have options to look at before they have to make another move down the middle, because they drafted these guys. They drafted Hedel and they drafted Anderson to be centers. They drafted Kravtsov and Kako to be wings, obviously, but they drafted Hedel and Anderson to be centers, so they want them to be centers. Hedel played the wing last year, and I think he might be better suited in that position. Gives him a little bit more creativity. He's a creative player, but that being said, if they want him to be a center, he will be a center at some point. Maybe this season, but it depends on what they do with Kreider.
All right, at Madison Square Garden, the Knicks did not get the big fish yesterday in the NBA free agency. The Rangers do. They get Artemi Panarin on a 7-year contract, a pretty good one. Guys?